Hello YouTube, welcome to today's video where today I will be walking you through 5 very simple and easy steps to speed up your PC. Now I know the people watching this are probably having troubles either running games or editing, and I just want to preface this by saying these are 5 things that you can be doing on a monthly basis to help keep away from those problems, but it may not be the source of yours. You may have to clear some cash or buy a new computer. I don't know. Diving right into it, we're going to head to the Windows settings. So to do that, we're going to go to the Windows button here and then click settings. There will be 3 places that we will be heading to, the first being our system. Once clicking on that, scroll all the way down to the bottom, go to your graphics settings, make sure that hardware accelerated GPU scheduling is turned on. Next, back in the settings menu, we're going to go to our apps. Disk space and computer speed do have a correlation beyond some people saying that it does not. Mostly because of the startup apps that run on your computer. In case some of these apps do start up and they have programs that are running as soon as you hit the on button, scroll through this list, click on whatever you don't want, and click uninstall. Next, we'll head to the startup button. In this list, you'll get a bunch of different apps that will be running as soon as you turn on your computer. Next to it, it'll also have the impact that it has on your computer. Make sure that all the ones that you do not want running are turned off. If you need another place to find this exact same menu, go down to the taskbar, right click, hit task manager, and then hit startup. Back in the settings tab, we're gonna go into our privacy. Windows likes to reach inside your little bitty baby computer and grab anything it possibly can, meaning that there are programs running these executions, meaning we have to just turn all of it off. So going through this entire list, you will find different on sections. Read through what they say. If you know an app that needs it, turn it back on. If you run into any privacy problems on your apps, see which one they're talking about and turn those back on. Some applications do not let you run without being able to see certain things on your computer, which probably isn't that great, but the least we can do is take a majority of these off. So again, go down this list, hit off on everything. I know I said we're going to 3 places, but I will give you a bonus. Inside of the gaming tab here, you're gonna wanna make sure that game mode is turned on. It does optimize your computer for PC play. However, a lot of the same mechanics are used in both editing and playing video games. We can X out of this menu and onto our next one. Disk cleanup on hard drives. The number one importance to a computer is the information that it's pulling from, stored inside of the hard drives. So making sure that you do some maintenance on your hard drives is kind of essential to making sure that your hard drive lasts as long as it possibly can. To do this, we'll go down to the search bar and type in File Explorer. Inside of File Explorer, you're gonna wanna make sure that you click on this PC and then head to your D drive. You're gonna right click on your D drive and go into Properties. There's this button here that says Disk Cleanup. This is going to get rid of things like shader files and also what's in your recycling bin. You're going to click it and then click OK. Once that's done running, you're going to head up to the Tools tab. And then we're just going to check for errors on this drive. You'll click on your main or your D drive. I've been told to not retrim solid state drives. That may just be a superstition, but I haven't done it. Feel free to look it up and prove me wrong. However, all I do is optimize my hard disk drives. And so click on your hard disk drive and then click optimize. After those run, we're going to exit that window and then click OK. You're going to do the exact same thing with your C drive. Just run your disk cleanup, and I would not recommend error checking or optimize or defragmenting your solid state drive if you have a solid state drive. If you do not have a solid state drive and you just have hard drives, feel free to do it on both. Again, I could be spreading a little bit of information that just isn't true. However, a quick Reddit search would probably change my mind, but I've been doing it for so long that at this point, it doesn't matter. We'll exit out of that. We'll exit out of File Explorer. Man, it's almost 5 minutes. We gotta get rolling here. Next, we're going to hit Windows R, and everybody probably knows this already. However, if you will type in percentage and then temp and then percentage, it'll bring you, after you hit OK, to a window of all of your temp files that your computer is using right now. And let me tell you something, if you use After Effects, you better be doing this daily, because I constantly delete 100, 150, 200 to 300 gigabytes a day after doing After Effects renders. You're just gonna Control A, delete, and then all the ones that cannot be completed because it's running inside of a program, you're just going to hit this button, do for all items, and then click skip. because that's what your computer is needing to use right now in order to run the applications that you have open. Next thing to do is change your power mode. Down in the search bar, you're going to type in power and click on power and sleep settings. Head over to additional power settings and make sure that this is set on high performance. Last thing to do is a very optional one, but I would recommend it. It's changing your advanced system settings. It's kind of like the look of your computer in order to get more performance rather than like the clean look. Down in the search bar, you're going to type advanced and then view advanced system settings should pop up. In the performance, you're going to hit settings. And then as you can see, I've kind of already chosen the ones that I am okay with losing. As you can see, I've already chosen the ones that I'm okay to live without. If you click on adjust for best performance, which is recommended to get the most out of your computer, your Windows 10 computer will look like it's Windows XP. Not what I really wanted, so I left some of these guys still checked, but I'll let you be the judge of it and also try it out for yourself because it's kind of funny. After you're done doing that, you're going to click apply and then okay. I'd recommend copying all of these, by the way. And that's it for my 5 quick tips to speed up your PC no matter what. These are 5 things that are known to work. I hope and wish the best for each and every one of you that this speeds up your computer tremendously. If you are looking into other quick tips on either speeding up your computer or speeding up your editing workflow life, feel free to check out the channel down below. I have some videos down there that everybody can benefit from. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.